Welcome to the Dream Speaker Business Journal in our new 3-in-1 format. Hi, my name's Joe Murtaugh, and I'm hoping that you can relax and continue to watch today's 7-minute workshop. But if you prefer to read or participate in our blog, click on the link directly below this screen. Let's get right to the workshop. The B-Web, Business Web Advantage. As a result of this workshop, you and your organization will understand how B-Webs can slash the cost of communications and transactions that render old ways obsolete. By internetworking, three types of knowledge assets gain human capital without owning it through new business models and focus on meeting well-defined existing and underserved customer needs rather than making something and then trying to sell it. Record companies and broadcast networks traditionally held a tight grip on the $38 billion music distribution business. They got blown up in 1991 when a German industrial electronics research firm called the Fraunhofer Institute released MP3. By 1998, millions of young people had started creating MP3 music content and software tools on the internet. 500,000 music files were available on the net for free downloading, despite the fact it was illegal. In that year alone, piracy cost the traditional music industry $10 billion. The MP3 and iPod are perfect examples of a B-Web. They were created using a distinctive system of suppliers, distributors, commerce service providers, infrastructure providers, and customers of all types who use the internet for the business of communications and transactions. Your organization can also become a B-Web based by relying on internet infrastructure to slash the cost of business communications and transactions while developing a unique new value proposition that renders the old way of doing things obsolete. Simply put, by internetworking, you can gain three types of knowledge assets: human capital without owning it, customer capital from complex mutual relationships, and structural capital that builds wealth through new business models. Organizations are now able to bring together the contributions of many participating enterprises, including customers who both receive and contribute to the value of the B-Web. Context providers furnish the interface between the customer and the B-Web, and content providers design, make, and deliver the goods, services, and the information that satisfy customer needs. There are also commerce service providers who enable the flow of business, including transactions and financial management, security, privacy, logistics, and delivery, and regulatory services. In addition, there are infrastructure providers who deliver communications and computing, electronic and physical records, roads, buildings, offices, and the like. Even though cooperative, the owners of B-Web still engage in competition because participants both cooperate and compete with one another to maximize their individual return on capital. They are customer-centric. Rather than making something and then trying to sell it, B-Webs focus on meeting customer needs. Some B-Webs allow participants to discover prices like eBay, a sell-side internet-based auction. Free markets, a buy-side auction, enables a buyer to receive bids from several sellers, becoming an innovative online business procurement site. Economic theory suggests that auctions and exchanges are far more rational than fixed price systems because they can continually adjust prices to meet supply and demand. You must also understand that you can replace the self-defeating tactics of the gross profit business agenda with the customer satisfaction business agenda by selling a lot of product, and you don't need to worry about making a large gross profit on any one item. If the number one priority of your business becomes making people happy, no matter what the cost, they will do business with you again and again. In essence, you shorten the trading cycle, thereby getting people to buy from you more often. Some B-Webs may want to emulate Walmart by positioning themselves as a value-added intermediary between producers and consumers. Another model is Home Advisor, Microsoft's buying web offering a total solution from searching to financing to crime and school statistics, all under one virtual roof. In a value chain, the context provider structures and directs a B-Web network to produce a highly integrated value proposition. The output meets a specific customer order. It might be that the individual's purchasing a Jeep with a custom trim or Quaker State delivering 20,000 cases of oil. In both cases, the seller has the final say on pricing. Meanwhile, distributive networks keep the economy alive and mobile. In addition to the roads, postal services, telecommunication companies, and electronic power grids of the industrial economy, distributed networks of today would also include data network operators and infrastructure providers. The point is that everyone has become interconnected, and those who are not connected at all will become disconnected. Okay, thanks for viewing, and special thanks to Charlotte-based Episode 11 for filming and VBiz Mail for delivering this workshop to you. No one has an exclusive on good ideas, and so we hope that you will share yours with us and tell us what you think. Just click on the blog tab right below your screen and keep in mind the Dream Speaker for any keynotes, workshops, or consulting that you may need in the future. Simply call 800-239-0058 and watch your email for the next workshop on May 7th.